Ciao a tutti, io sono Veronica e questo video sarà un po' diverso dal solito. Durante questo periodo gli scambi giovanili Erasmus+ sono tutti bloccati causa Covid, quindi ho deciso di partecipare ad uno scambio virtuale, praticamente la stessa cosa ma avviene tutto online. Lo scambio al quale ho partecipato aveva come focus la sostenibilità e per questo come report finale ho deciso di fare un video esplicativo su come essere sostenibili in viaggio. Spero ti piaccia e ti ricordo di mettere mi piace e iscriverti al canale per non perderti i prossimi video. Buona visione! Did you know that tourism is the fourth leading cause of CO2 emissions? And its ecological footprint is unfortunately destined to increase with the growth in the number of tourism in the world. That means no more traveling? Don't worry, the natural and historical beauty of our place can be preserved and improved thanks to sustainable tourism. It reduces CO2 emissions, which is why it helps to slow down climate change. Furthermore, sustainable tourism respects the environment and landscapes, contributing to their protection and enhancements. Now, I want to share with you 5 good practices to organize a sustainable trip. The first practice for responsible travel is to choose sustainable modes of transport, such as the train, bike sharing services, electric car, public transport, or your own legs. As for food, it's better to choose the products made on the spot to promote the local economy and taste in a sustainable way. As for accommodation instead, it is always better to choose hotels, B&Bs, and farmhouses that operate with low environmental impact, enhancing the territory. Use e-tickets. In the digital age, paper tickets are no longer needed because it is enough to keep them on your smartphone using one of the many apps to choose from. Last but not least, leave prejudice at home. Dive yourself in the culture of the place, respect local customs and traditions and different lifestyles. This is the best way to rediscover the value of comparing with a different culture. Respect is the key word of every trip. In conclusion, I would like to talk to you about how to make sustainable tourism in my region, Abruzzo. It has been called the green heart of Europe for its rich biodiversity. Every nature-loving tourist is spoiled for choice between cycled routes such as the Via Verde dei Trabocchi, the large national parks such as the Gran Sasso and Maiella National Parks, the blue flag beaches such as the magical Punta Aderci, and the hill and mountains villages such as Rocca Calascio and Scanno. Have a good trip!